but we want to be up there to presumably get on the train ride. Well, I'm not sure. Doesn't look like there's anything else over here. That's not totally true. Network uplink. Okay. So these bridges, we're gonna have to get to these little points to continue deeper to get to the core, it looks like. That guy's gonna throw me off. It's just like, it's almost overwhelming. I feel like we could easily miss things here, but... That is freaking wild. Should I be... There we go. Cauldron core, here we come. I had no idea these would be this huge. First of all, I didn't know what a cauldron was. Second of all, once we stepped inside, it was like, oh, okay, it's gonna be some type of, like, cave.
Almost to the heart.
Little did I know. You know what I think I'm gonna do? Let's actually do this. So instead of this, rope caster that I haven't used yet. I think I'm gonna throw the sharp shot bow up top. Now, in order to craft these things, like, these are very expensive, these terror blast arrows. But, I mean, we have the stuff. Yeah, so this is significantly more damage. 60 compared to 17, but in terms of, like, the armor break, it's actually not too different. Here, the armor break's 100, so no damage, but 100 armor break. So, okay, now I'm starting to pick up exactly on what's happening there. Actually, I'm wondering, when we craft these, so I just had 39 out of 40, I wonder if we're wasting materials, because it says it's like, to craft 10 of them costs that much. I wonder if it, like, prorates that, or if it is wasteful the way that we do it sometimes. Oh, we got something over here. Damn it.
I'll shake it out later.
I'll shake it out later, no big deal. Oh, we've reached the core. Override. This is not going to be easy. Energy emission tower of unknown design may provide access to the facility's central processor.
This is how machines are made.
So there's these four, like...
Light.
Oh, look at this.
There's signals coming up from all over the place.
A fire bellowbox being created. Can we stay in the shadows here for a second? I don't see any vents. But I am wondering. If we can't climb up there. Doesn't look like we can. We've gotten his attention. Maybe we'll override one? Too late. Panicked. Oh, wait. Maybe they're on the... Oh, they're on the front. Jesus! That... Okay, so wait a second. Wait a second. So we lower those things, and then it's like, it's on. So maybe it's better if... Like, can we not shoot that machine as it's being built there?
This is how machines are
woven out of light. So, weakness to damage, the gullet, the cargo sack. Strength is fire, but freeze would be good, obviously. So maybe instead of overriding right away, it doesn't do anything. All right, then. Get rid of these little guys first, hopefully. Oh! That'll do. We've fought Bellowbacks before! Shit. At least if we can get rid of those. This is insane. Get rid of some additional armor, I guess. Woohoo! That is frickin' awesome. This is the greatest thing that's ever happened to me. This is like, this is just awesome. I'm starting to really get a grasp of the combat now and like what makes sense to be doing in given scenarios. Nice, handling coil. Modification 19 of 20. Is handling kind of like speed?
I'd have to leave something else behind.
Freeze coil. I think that's fine. Like that one, I think we want though. Let's actually look at these weapons for a second. Why can't I click on these? Oh, it's in here, that's why. Modify them. Okay, so we've got extra handling. We can give it extra damage. Look at this, very rare. So the handling can get upped significantly, making it less kind of unwieldy. Get extra tear. I think we should use this. And then maybe swap for like the extra tear damage. instead of the 6% handling. And then over here, on our current bow, we've got plus 6 and plus 9 damage. We could give it fire. Give the fire a better boost. Why don't we do that? And then I think keeping... you know what? Let's use the uncommon. We get the damage and fire and tear, unless... Is it the same ones that go in here? No, it is not. Okay, cool. So let's take the 10% damage, plus 6 tear, and plus 6 fire. And then for the sling that we're obviously using, freeze, shock, and damage. Oh, you know what? I bet you we shouldn't have used that because we don't have shock on there right now. But I bet you if we get a better sling, it'll have shock. Okay, so we shouldn't have used that one, but regardless. I can kind of see where these are going to go after a while, and it's going to be insane, especially if we're just in this little arena. But if it does what we think it does, and lets us override other machines, that's huge, because not only can you ride some of them, that's like the minor part, actually, but they'll fight each other, which is great. That original little watcher that we overrode in the beginning, he did a lot of damage to that guy.
Information with different machines. This will help me override them.
Nice. Skill points, experience. We're gonna get a couple of skill points out of this then. Oh, and then it just takes us out. Oh, cool, man. Sigma overrides available. Sawtooth, scrappers, grazers, and lance horns. That's like everything that we're kind of currently running into. Which is, okay, so whenever we can get access to one of these cauldrons, that's gotta be like, we gotta do that ASAP, I think. Really, really cool. We have so many extra skills now, too. So, strike from below, maybe. Maybe. 50% damage increase to strike attacks. I guess that could be good. Dodge prowess. Hold circle for a long dodge roll or tap it for short. Move faster while wielding heavy weapons. I guess it kind of depends, like, what do we want to get to here? I think leader strike would be... obviously pretty immense. Take down on heavy and elite. Oh, this is human enemies. Combat override, increase the time a machine will remain overridden indefinitely. Maybe that's just what we grab right now. Weapon coils and outfit weaves can be removed and reused. That might be a good one. And then scavenger. Triple shot. Use R1 while aiming to notch up to 3 arrows at once on all bow weapons. Oh, damn. Double shot. Yeah, this is what we want. We want to be going down this path as well. Let's grab combat override because we're going to use that quite a bit at the moment. But let's grab heavy lifter just so that we can start getting into double shot and triple shot as well. Fast reload. Man, there's so many good ones here. We just have resist freeze here, but I think fire is probably better. It really depends on what we're going to be fighting, so. Okay. Oh, we've got a data point too. Sigma core log 763E. Machines. Cauldron core log. Production, oversight, analysis, active, additive, manufacture type, alert, intrusion, Source external. Active countermeasure phase shift. Alert intrusion denied. What? How cool is that?
One of these.
That's outstanding, quite honestly. You know what? On our way back, why don't we go here and find Tame's ring, gather the boar skins for her? I hear something. God damn, the turkeys make the weirdest noises. Oh, is it taking me deeper in this way? Yeah, okay. Weird.
I'll tuck that away.
He's injured. Aloy the boar hunter strikes again. There we go. Okay, that we want. If they keep their heads down like this, will they just not detect me? Oh, no. Shit. Come on over. Oh, shit. Did we call two? Oh. Oh, boy. Somebody come and investigate. I'm gonna override him. There we go. It's gonna blow. Isn't it? He's pissed. Fight with me. It's okay, Roach. Okay, hold on. Tame's ring. Is So boar skins are up ahead. Let's go and do that. There's some here too. Yeah, oh shit. Now, can we override these? This is a sawtooth, right? Override unlocked, yep. Oh! Oh, this is so cool! Let's go. Come with me. Is he just gonna follow me? Because that would be awesome. Okay, so that's all well and good. Oh, look at all the boars! You know what? Let's use this. And maybe we can take them down in, like, one hit. Yep. Because we can use a lot of this stuff for the pouches. Collect it before on our way back. Oh! Thank you.
Keep that for later.
Can barely see anything in here, I guess. This is what boar territory is like. They're fighting. Look at that! That is awesome! Like, and this guy, he's just gonna destroy anything. So goal number one in any, like, fight that we're gonna take is find something to override, for sure. And then, like, become best friends. Basically. Oh, poor boar. Overkill much? Yes. I know that's way more expensive to craft, but it just felt good. Now, can we override multiple things at one time? Is the other question.
Hardy little plant. You'll help.
I'm gonna guess the answer is no. But I could be wrong. There is a cooldown, so maybe you can. Like, I mean, I guess it only stays in that area anyway, so.
Hard to tell the tracks apart. But this was tame. And a boar.
You didn't see anything. Look at the grazers grazing.
Grazers. I can override them if I don't spook them.
I Look at him. Just turn on his buddies like that. That's good. Where are the tracks, though?
They know where I am.
Whoa. Following the track.
Wonder what killed it. Froth around the mouth.
What? Oh, it's inside? Lost ring.
Something caught in its throat. Let's see here.
Of course.
That would be Tame's ring.
Yum. And you know what we searched through to get that, right? Like, you must know. I'm sure you know. It looks like I saw that other one over here. And I think that we have both overridden. What's stopping me from becoming, like, a giant army? Oh, is he hostile again?
I know how to override a sawtooth.
Yeah, see, watch.
I'm getting close.
It's just, like, insane damage. We can override when he's stunned. We don't get the materials is the thing, right? It's too bad you can't mount all of them. Because that would be really cool. Okay, anyways. I think we're safe to, like, go back to the campfire here. We have 7 of these things. This is the greatest thing ever, honestly. Oh wait. Tame's right here.
I wonder if it's a big storm this time.
How did you fare on the hunt?
Well,
I've brought you the boar skins and your lucky ring, Tame.
All mother be praised.
And you, of course. Where did you find it?
Halfway down a boar's gullet. Not so lucky for the boar.
I think I'll wear it around my neck from now on.
Maybe clean it a bit. FYI. Got generous reward boxes. Okay, this is awesome. Free sample boxes. Oh, fast travel pack. Okay, let's go into our carry capacity here. What's holding us up? So we need boar, we didn't get any boar skin from that. That's actually kind of interesting. I wonder if that's just like a rare drop. We can upgrade our modification satchel with rich meat. We need fox bone. Fish bone there, turkey skin, rabbit bone, boar skin, raccoon bone, fish bone, rope caster we don't need to upgrade yet, and otherwise we're set. So I think what we should do is let's head in here. What are you guys shooting at? Oh, somebody told me that if we knock down all of these, there's like a trophy. And they're like, you're well on your way to knocking them all down, so may as well keep an eye out for them.
She saved many lives. The tribe is lucky to have her.
Man, It's much nicer being included than being an outsider, I'll tell you that much.
Well, I hope you're looking to buy. I could use the shards.
Ooh.
I'm heading for the border. You're a trader? What do you know of the Karja tribe or their capital, Meridian?
I've never left our sacred land, but I've traded with Karja outlanders from time to time. Too fancy for their own good, if you ask me. As for Meridian, it's all they talk about. A city built atop a mesa, with soaring towers, high as mountains.
How did the Karja ever come to build such marvels?
Slave labor. But their new king has forbidden slavery. I guess he cares more about justice than new construction, huh?
I mean...
See anything you like? Sure you do.
Okay, let's... We could probably get rid of a few things here. Selling for metal shards. I think that's probably about it. But let's see what he does have to buy here. So here's like a slightly better version of the bow that we have, I think. Karja Hunter Bow, so this would actually be better than the one that we have. We own this. This is the same thing. We have the Sharp Shot and the Hunter Bow. Right. The Karja Sling, this is the one that will have the shock, so I think we want that. It's not like we're low on shards here. And then the Trip Caster. This will do fire as well, it looks like. So we've got all these Karja weapons now. Oh, you know what? I probably should have just bought this. But we need a crystal braiding, of which we have no idea what that is, so that doesn't really matter. We could change our outfit, probably. Survivor Heavy. I wonder if it actually makes us slower. It has different effects. Like, this one protects 15 against kind of everything. And then these ones each have specific defenses. This one's for stealth. Makes us harder to see and hear. Man, really cool. Maybe we should just get, like, look at this, it's more of, like, heavier protection. Or we just grab this one, get defense against all the elements. Very expensive, it's like all of our shards, but it's not the end of the world. We didn't grab his sample box. Oh, what's this? Adds map markers hinting at the locations where metal flowers might be seen. Yes, these are so cheap. Banuk figures, don't know what those are, but look at all these ancient vessels. It gives us everything. Oh, that's so cool. I had no idea. And then I think we'll probably save for the Survivor Heavy, or maybe it's better to like specialize in these. You know, save up to buy each of these ones, and then, and then you just switch into them whenever you need to. I think maybe that's what we'll do. For now, let's go ahead and grab the Protector Light. There we go. Okay.
Well, I'll be off. I hope business picks up.
Thanks. Me too.
Look at that. Okay, now our map's gonna be frickin' crazy. Are you kidding me? Oh, it shows the entire region? Whoa. Can we filter any of those? Like, I don't even know what a vantage is. Anyways, okay, we got lots to do. I'm gonna take a break here. When we come back, let's just review what we should look at. Maybe it's better, instead of running way out to that other corrupted zone, we should probably go and meet up with Varl and Sona. They're up to the north here, which is, I guess, equidistant from here to here, but this is like going into a whole other zone. So I think it makes sense to stay here for right now. What else do we have going on? We have to find June, who's like way far to the left. It's actually not that far. It's actually not that far. We have a metal flower up there. I don't know what that is. I think this is our original campfire, is it not? Go to Day Tower. Upgrade these things. Oh, these are the jobs that we created. We can just abandon these just to kind of keep things clean. Bandit camps, tall necks. These are the hunting grounds. Cauldron's done, corrupted zone. Very cool. Okay, thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you're enjoying. We'll see you in the next one. Take care. Bye.